good.
Well, Stan Simpson complained about us, so we got a visit from the environmental officer. Of course, because there are no restrictions in coming here, didn't really have a problem with it. Just wanted to know who we were and what we're doing.
He had 6,000 heavy equipment pieces on the trail, and he had about 2,000 small vehicles where he did. Most of them were right and drive, like you've seen.
We saw, yeah.
They were made by Ford for the British military, and the war was in full swing, and he canceled the contract. What the heck were we going to do with those Yukoner trails? So all the vehicles that you see, they were the wrecked ones. They were not, you know, mobile on their own, so they left them behind. But everything that could run, they take them out. There's a legend, or a little further out, just down, there's 12 Harley Davidsons with sidecars, brand new in the frame, buried in the ground. I've been looking for those. I've been looking for them. Never find them. We even met the cab driver in Ross River, who was about 90 now, to try to tell us, because he remembered burying them, but he was pretty old. He didn't really remember. But we had lots of fun. We did lots of different surveys and programs in here. And it's all in the effort to bring people to come and see it. Like in my mind, whatever vehicle you use or whatnot, as long as people come.
Drove all the way up.
That's beautiful. Like if you guys would be able to cross that Twitcha, you'd get up in the plains of Abraham, where it's a heavily glaciated area, like the mountain, there's no peak, they're all nice and round. You guys could go everywhere with the trucks on there. But you climb up to 6,800 feet. Like the hoodoos are 400 million years old, left intact.
How deep is this?
Deepest about 1,700 feet.
Whoa. The canyon?
Yeah, we get right in it.
No!
It's 22 miles from North Wales. It's a long...
What would it cost for a flight of that thing?
It depends. People, we had an expedition. They came from... They were from the States. They were sponsored by B.F. Goodrich.
Oh.
Had designed the new tires. They used Ford. Ford diesel, four doors, one-ton truck. They put the tire about that big on the suspension. I think it was a 21-inch lift kit on it. And B.F. Goodrich said, follow the winter road all the way to Fort Hope, past Northern Wales. They went to Inuvik on the Mackenzie River with the jagged ice and everything. All the people in town, the native people, they said, never, nobody can do that. And they did. They made it all the way to Inuvik.
So when you start telling the story to the Northern Wales,
but you guys,
there's a Land Rover, it's not Jeeps.
Yes, I know. I drive a new Land Cruiser at home.
Oh, yeah.
Was before the airstrip. Where there's a lot of old drums and old trucks.
Yeah.
We found an old drum from 98 with the jet fuel.
Oh, yeah.
And is that, that's, you can't use that.
Oh, yeah, they use here. There's no fungus that creating the fuel. Like down south, the fungus.
Here he can drive a small wheel in town.
Do you know who it belongs to?
Me, the other company, but I'm the only one pretty much in the north here. But they'll be doing some project, forest fire sometime. Government be left behind.
So it's going to rust and leak into the ground.
Maybe.
So it'd be a good idea for us to pick it up and get rid of it.
If you wanted to, a market to put it right on the trail.
Oh, hey, I read the paper.
They just did another assessment. They just finished before you guys came in. They used quad, and we bumped them with helicopter across the rivers and stuff.
Because the diesel can burn out. It would be okay for us to take it?
You got to check. If it's jet B on it, you can. If it's jet A, you can.
It's B.
It's B? It's burning your truck.
Right, what's wrong with Jet A?
Jet A is because of the Jet A is a kerosene-based fuel. Jet B is a naphtha-based, so it's good for us. The kerosene, they put so much anti-icing additive in there. Your injector is not gonna like that. But Jet B, you can put it right in.
Really?
Oh yeah. Absolutely.
Thank you. What a day we've had. We just are surrounded by trees and bush, and we've been cutting wood. We've had landslides, we've dug around, and we've had washouts we've had to dig out. And we've had some close calls, but it's getting too late, dark, we can't drive anymore in the dark. And so we're stopped here on the trail, and it's really dismal. The spirits are down a bit, but it'll pick up in the morning. It's a beautiful clear sky. We like to get down to the river off and get off this road. It's following the river, but it's just treed in, and we have to cut what's, you know, when it's too narrow, which is often, and they're big. So it's tough, and we haven't got that far today, and we only got 2 days left.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this task and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
grizzly right in the middle of the road.
Did you get a picture?
So Pete, looks like we've bumped to mile 152.5.
I saw it jump. There's spears pointing at you, man.
Open her up. Let's see what's in there. the wheel straight. Look at me, Dave. Wheel straight. Straighten it out. Right to the right. Straight. Keep coming. Nice and easy, Dave. Nice and easy. Are you ready?
Yep.
Good. Thank you.
check station. We have sport hunters from the Northwest Territories that come in here, resident hunters. We have non-resident Canadian hunters that come in here, go with the outfitters. We have non-resident alien hunters that are non-Canadian from other parts of the world that come in with the outfitters, that come and harvest. They come for later in the season, moose, the caribou, woodland mountain caribou. They end up with doll sheep, wolf, wolverine. And then we get the Aboriginal hunters. Like our whole life cycle was based on following the behaviors of animals and their movements and their cycle and the way that they migrate in this part of the region.
Well, you could see it in his eyes as they streamed against the night, and the bone white knuckle grip upon the road. 65 miles into town, and the winter's thirst to drown, a winter still with 2 months left to go. His eyes are too far open, his grin too hard and sore, his shoulders too far high to bring relief. But the Copper King is hot, even if the band is not, and it sure beats shooting whiskey jacks and trees. Says it didn't get me this time, not tonight. I wasn't screaming when I hit the door, but his hands on the tabletop, will their shaking never stop? Those hands sweep the bottles to the floor. Now he's a bear in a blood-red Mackinaw, with hungry dogs at bay and springtime thunder in his sudden roar. With one wrong word he burns, and the tables overturn. When he's finished, there's a dead man on the floor. Well, they watched for him in Carmack, Haynes, and Carcross. With Teslin Block, there's nowhere else to go. But he hit the four-wheel drive in Johnson's Crossing. Now he's 38 miles up the Canol Road. He's 38 miles up the Canol Road. In the Salmon Range at 48 below. Well, it's God's own neon green above the mountains here tonight, throwing brittle colored shadows on the snow. It's 4 more hours till dawn, and the gas is almost gone, and that bitter Yukon wind begins to blow. Now you can see it in his eyes as they glitter in the light, and the bone white rime of frost around his brow. Too late, the dawn has come, that Yukon winter's won, and he's got his cure for cabin fever now. Well, they watched for him in Carmack's, Haynes, and Carcross. With Teslin Block, there's nowhere else to go. But they hit the four-wheel drive in Johnson's Crossing, found him 38 miles up the Canol Road. They found him 38 miles up the Canol Road. In the Salmon Range at 48 below. They found him 38 miles up the Canol Road.
I took a rock through the windshield. I had the wrong type of windshield. A tempered glass instead of safety glass, and so it blew the whole windshield out. So what we did, it was right in my face. We took the passenger side windshield and put it in the driver's side windshield. And then Dave found a camper, in the wrecked camper, and it had a piece of glass that we decided was just about the right size, that we're going to tape it on the outside of the truck. As you can see, we're taping it now, and we're hoping that this will work so we can carry on.